Hi everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So today I'm just going to do a quick arts and crafty type video to show you guys how to build a pinhole sun viewer. This is the same thing that I built back in 2003 to view the Venus transit. Of course, I was about 11 or 12 back then, so I guess this is a project that a little kid could do. So I got a bunch of stuff here, let's put it together. So what I've got here is a couple of empty Pringles cans, some Dixie cups, I'll probably only need one. Some tin foil and parchment paper, which I may or not use. Some duct tape, scissors, magnifying lens, and a push pin. Okay, so first thing we need is a pinhole. Just take the metal part of the can, stick the pin through it here. Try to get towards the center. So now if I line this up with the sun, you can see down here on the pavement, you can see a little spot of light. The farther away I get, the bigger that spot gets. And that spot is, of course, an image of the sun. See, if I move my hand in front of the sun, you can see, you know, it. And I'm eclipsing it there, and you actually can see, you know, the sun being eclipsed. That's, of course, what the moon will be doing here in about a month. So, that's the easy part. Effectively, I now have a camera. But to make it something that we can actually use as a viewer, we're going to be hooking the two of these cans together and using a magnifying lens to increase the size of the image. I'm just cutting off the bottom of one of the cans, and the whole idea here is to give this a longer tube, give the light more time to spread out. I'll just tape these together. Seems the sidewalk is not exactly level, is it? Okay, so now that I've got the tubes put together into one long tube, I just need this cup here. I'm going to cut the bottom off of it. Doesn't have to look super pretty. Goodbye, tube. Now we've got this long tube with a pinhole at the end. I'm going to cut this Pringles thing right about at the focal length of the magnifying lens. I'm going to just measure that real quick. Looks like just a bit shorter than those scissors are. So those like to fit about there. So right about there. Doesn't have to be perfect, but it's gotta be close. Gotta sort of trim up the edges so they're smooth. So now this piece that's right here, which is got this smoothed over lip, take this. Now we're gonna stretch our screen over it. I'm gonna actually use this plastic bag because recycling, right? So stretch it tight, and then you take some of that tape, hand me that tape, and I'm just going to tape this on and cut off the excess of the bag. There we go, our screen. So what this is, it's going to let most of the light through, but it'll stop some, so you can actually see the image of the sun on the plastic, just like this. Let me finish just trimming this up. So now I'm going to take this and tape it right there, just like that. Turns out they don't make cups quite as tough as they used to make them, so I'm having to put two of these cups together. I'm just gonna cut off the bottom of the cup so that you can see through it to a point where it's the same size as the Pringles can. This, of course, is the adapter that I'm gonna be using to tape the magnifying lens to. Now for the magnifying lens, which I'll just tape on just like that. There's the magnifying lens stuck on there. Let's see if this thing works. And it sure does. Here, see? There you can see the image of the sun. I've taped it up completely so that it looks a little bit better. And now all we need is something to see. Anything that gets in front of the sun should show up on this. It'll be reversed because of the way that the light works when it goes through. You know, apart from the sun, this side will wind up on the opposite side, kind of like that. But it also expands the image so you can see it better. So we got a little bit of cloud cover there. You can see there's a light pole. Let's move the sun so the light pole is partially covering it right there. And now let's use our little viewfinder to see how it looks. All right, there you can see it. My camera's having trouble focusing, but you can kind of see the shadow of the street lamp
on the clouds there even. I'm just gonna walk forward a little bit so I can partially cover the sun. There you go. You can actually really see it really well.
Here's something that I think is a little bit more interesting than the street light though. See these power lines?
They have a shadow on the ground that you can see, but it's not a full shadow. This is a, you know, very much a penumbral shadow here, because it doesn't completely block out the sun for this distance that we have. All right, so there's the image of the sun. I'll walk forward. I have one of those wires crossed in front of it. There we go. It's really hard to get the camera to focus on that. You can see the line going through the sun there.
As you may have guessed, this is not only useful for viewing solar eclipses and transits, but you can also take some interesting pictures, like if you can somehow set this up so that an airplane flies across the sun, you can see that. I've used it to take a picture of a windmill with the sun as a backdrop, all sorts of things. So there you go, a little simple device that allows you to look at the sun. See, it takes this pinhole and it expands it to a larger size so the intensity is not quite as much so it doesn't hurt your eyes anymore. Still, use caution. The magnifying lens is not extremely necessary, but it's nice because it makes the image a little bit larger. One of the problems with the eclipse glasses is the sun's still only about the size of a pea held at arm's length. But this makes the image of the sun a little bit larger, maybe about the size of a dollar coin held at arm's length. So not huge, but certainly a lot larger. Anyway, hope you all enjoyed. I'll see you next time.